The Uganda Revenue Authority, URA Commissioner General John Musinguzi, yesterday signed an MOU launching a joint taxpayer education initiative dubbed Buza Commissioner. This initiative follows taxpayers' plea for increased tax education, especially targeting traders and other presumptive taxpayers. During the launch, John Musinguzi urged taxpayers to send in their tax inquiries, service experience, and general feedback on how the taxman can serve the nation better.
Really come to appreciate that the biggest barrier that stops people from paying their fair share of tax is lack of adequate information. And we end up, you know, running after them, penalizing them for non-compliance. Kumbe, the only reason why they are not compliant is that they didn't have enough information to make decisions. So we did a structure review, and one of the areas which we have promoted into the whole division, but also given the resources in terms of personnel and expertise, is the tax education group.
With this Buza Commission initiative, taxpayers will be able to relay their queries and sentiments through Vision Group's platforms such as Bukede TV One, Bukede Paper, and Bukede Online. On receiving concerns, the URA top leadership will receive them and responses published every Wednesday on the Bukede paper. John Onyama, the Vision Group CEO, said there is little information about tax among the general public and that he believes that this initiative will create a paradigm shift.
We are going to put out the platforms on which people can send their questions, and I think it will be across board. They can call, they can WhatsApp, they can email, whatever. We're going to put out all these platforms so that we are able to get these questions and then we pass them to you.
The first phase of the Buza Commissioner campaign is expected to last a period of 3 months. The Court of Appeal has commenced the hearing of 25 criminal appeals at Mbarara High Court. The 3-day session will be presided over by Lady Justice Eva Luswata, Justice Oscar Chiyika, and Dr. Asa Mukenyi. The Deputy Chief Justice, Honorable Justice Richard Butera, who led the team of justices, decried the low number of judges, saying that out of the required 17 judges, they only have 13 judges.
Is it worth continuing that case here and one judge gives a judgment in his opinion, instead of these people finding a solution for themselves that settles their disputes?
Justice Butera highlighted arbitration and mediation as mechanisms that should be adopted for conflict resolution as a means of reducing case backlog and expediting justice. He added that this also ensures a fair trial with minimal sentences.
And this can be done, we have tried it. We do mediation, we do arbitration, we have used small claims.
The Mbarara High Court Judge Justice Joyce Kavuma said they have 4,440 cases for hearing and that they have embraced strategies that ensure reduction of case backlog in the district.
And given the workload, we are embracing the strategies of ADR, that is alternative dispute resolution. We are doing well in the area of plea bargaining.
The case list signed by the court's deputy registrar Lilian Buchana indicates that out of the 25 appeals to be handled, murder constitutes the majority of the appeals with 12 cases. Aggravated defilement follows with 11 appeals, rape and aggravated robbery with 1 appeal each. People in Nigeria's biggest city, Lagos, bemoan the traffic jams and petrol station queues caused by fuel shortages in the oil-rich West African nation. Weeks of fuel scarcities are compounding a cost of living crisis, with the state-run oil company acknowledging financial strain was hampering supplies. Nigeria, a major African oil producer, often sees sporadic fuel shortages that cause long lines at NNPCL, a run petrol station that sell fuel at cheaper prices than private operators. Though an OPEC oil producer, Nigeria imports most of its fuel needs because it has very little refining capacity.
The first cut is very hard. We always look harder to see fuel. Sometimes when you reach the first station, don't even allow bikes to enter. they'll block the roads, then you have to fight for and struggle for the first scarcity. When you enter the filling station still, you have to wait for queue. Something that you're supposed to buy, we used to buy in 10 minutes, 2 minutes before. Now we take it like almost 30 to 45 minutes.
Africa's most populous country is already struggling under high living costs after government reforms to end a fuel subsidy and free the Naira currency drove a spike in inflation.